When I met Sibongile Sikhuze last year, he had just survived the worst episode of police violence in post-apartheid South Africa. 34 striking Lonmin Platinum mine workers shot dead during a protest over low wages. He was lucky. The bullets that hit him were rubber bullets.
The bullet went in here and came out on the other side.
The bloody confrontation happened a week into the strike. A month later, the Lonmin workers had their pay increased by up to 22%. The Marikana massacre, as it became known, sparked similar minor protests across the country, costing South Africa at least $1 billion in lost production, and probably much more in image and reputation. Police Chief Ria Piecha is among those being interrogated at a commission of inquiry set up to investigate the shootings. Sikhuze supports the investigation, but says the physical and emotional scars will stay with him for as long as he lives.
Sometimes I get nightmares. I still can't believe I made it out alive.
He shows me his improved pay. From $500 a month to nearly $780 is a significant leap, though much less than the miners were demanding. Sikhuze complains that with 8 dependents, it's still not enough. Though it has made it possible for him to enroll his 10-year-old son in school. The lost production and the hefty pay hikes that followed created huge financial losses for Lonmin, and the company has been forced to restructure.
On the 1st of July, Lonmin Platinum Mine will have a new CEO.
Zimbabwean mining engineer Ben Magara has 22 years' experience in South Africa's mining industry.
He will be among the very few black mining CEOs in South Africa.
To Sikhuze, whether the new boss is black or white is immaterial.
It was black policemen who shot at us and killed my colleagues. Whether the CEO is black, white, is no indication of how he will treat us.
It pains him, he says, that he still lives in a one-room shack. And while the Marikana tragedy has drawn worldwide attention to their plight, it's likely going to take more than change at the top to improve the lives of South Africa's 500,000 miners. Nkepile Mabuse, CNN, Marikana.